Talking now with probably the hottest undrafted free agent in the entire 2020 class. The dollars would say so. AJ Green, cornerback from Oklahoma State, now cornerback for the Cleveland Browns. And listen, the draft is the draft. You don't have a choice on where you go. But when you are as hotly valued as you are, or hotly contested as you were, you get to pick. And that's something that's unique coming into the NFL. So just walk us through this process. How did you decide you wanted to be a Cleveland Brown?
Deciding to be a Cleveland Brown, I talked to Coach Lynch at the Combine, and I talked to him before. And I kind of like what he stood for and what he was saying. Looked at the depth chart and things, and I felt this was somewhere I could make an impact early. And you got two pretty good corners, and Greedy and Denzel, and I just kind of want to come here and just kind of make an impact any way I can and as soon as I can.
Now, for those who didn't get an opportunity to watch a lot of your college tape, you know, semifinalist for the Thorpe Award, which is awarded to the nation's best defensive back, which goes to your now teammate, Grant Delpit, this past season as well. And listen, you had all conference honors, et cetera, down there in the Big 12. How would you describe your game? What kind of a corner are you?
I would say I'm a physical corner, a good press man corner, but also have the variety and the things from Arsenal to switch it up and be just as good at all. I would say I'm very intelligent when it comes to playing the corner game. I've been playing it all my life. Been playing it for a minute now, so I kind of understand and have a feel. I didn't play it at the college level where all they do is throw the ball, so yeah. I kind of know how it is. But also come up and make tackles. So I'll just say I have a pretty complete all-around game, and I just want to prove that.
Yeah, a lot of people very, very surprised that your name was not called on draft day. But now that it's all worked out in the way that it has, and you saw the money that you got from the Cleveland Browns, is it one of those things that's weird? Like, yes, I obviously you wanted to be drafted, but at the same time, you have something that somebody who was picked in, say, the sixth or seventh round doesn't have, and that's the opportunity to decide exactly where you want to go and have people, in this case, bidding for your services. So that probably had to feel pretty good given that it went the way that it did during the draft.
Yes, of course. Watching the draft, I was very frustrated, kind of angry and things like that. And, I mean, they took 50 DBs, and I wasn't one of them. But then God had a plan for me, and it all came down into the draft. Towards the end of the draft, I was getting calls and things like that. And I kind of like Cleveland Brown, what they stood for, like the coaching staff, like Coach Woods and what he wants to do. So I just felt it was the best decision for me, and I stuck with it and made it.
Does that put a chip on your shoulder?
Oh, yes, no doubt. Yeah.
A boulder?
Yeah, it puts it out. It puts it, yeah, no doubt. I'm just trying to be the best I can. I'm trying to be the best in this league. I have goals and things I want to accomplish in this league. And yeah, I just kind of want to wake everybody up and just kind of make them regret not picking me, whatever team regret not selecting me.
Well, certainly there's three right off the top of my mind that I would love to see you make regret. That's Baltimore, Pittsburgh, and Cincinnati in our division. And, you know, you look at this division all of a sudden, a lot of talent at the quarterback position, a lot of talent at the wide receiver position. You think about the Ravens, the reigning MVP in Lamar Jackson, not to mention you are very familiar with Hollywood Brown, his top receiver down there who went there. And then you got another A.J. Green. I don't know why, you know, another A.J. Green down in Cincinnati and the guys Juju and et cetera there. And Ben Roethlisberger coming back, Joe Burrow going to Cincy, Ben in Pittsburgh. This is going to be a pretty fun division. Or certainly at least a challenging one to be a DB in.
Yes, no doubt. And coming from the college I came from, I did nothing but go against the top receivers.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I didn't face the Hollywoods. I didn't face the CDs. I didn't face the Ragers. I practiced with Tyler every day in practice. I didn't win against James Washington, who's with the Steelers.
Yeah.
So, I mean, wide receiver talent, it isn't new to me. And also quarterbacks, I didn't play against Mahomes. I played against Baker, who's now the quarterback for the Browns. So I just kind of play, I would say, with top-tier talent. So I'm just ready to step up to the challenge and show what I can do.
Is it interesting having gone against Baker when he was at Oklahoma? And we know that rivalry, Oklahoma, Oklahoma State, and then now you guys are all of a sudden teammates.
Yes. It's always great playing in that Bedlam rivalry. I do have memory against Baker, though. I caught an interception first drive and at home at our place, and it was lit up. So, I mean, it was great. He's a competitor. He knows how to win. He's going to find a way to win, and I'm ready to roll with him.
Have you guys gotten a chance to talk since you've joined the team? And if so, did you remind him about that interception?
No, we haven't got a chance to talk yet.
I'm sure that it will come up on the practice field, and yeah, I'm sure you. No doubt. That's a nice little feather in your cap to walk into the room with, I would say.
No doubt. I feel like a lot of emotions and things, and just competing against each other on the practice field is going to come up.
Well, you compete against him, and then you look around, you got a guy you probably heard of, Odell Beckham Jr., Jarvis Landry. So you're going to get a pretty good baptism by fire in these practices. There's going to be a lot of iron sharpening iron out there.
Oh, yes, no doubt. I'm going out there. They're going to know me from day one because obviously everybody knows those guys. So I'm more slipped under the radar, but they definitely going to find out who I am from day one and on.
So when I mentioned earlier going through the division, I mentioned the other A.J. Green, obviously, the Bengals from Georgia had an excellent, excellent career. How often do you hear that? Are you sick of that? I mean, and now it's kind of funny because you're going to be going against the Bengals twice a year here with the Browns.
I hear it a lot. As I started to play football more and people thought, you're pretty good. It just came more, are you this A.J. Green? Are you the A.J. Green? Anything like that. So now that we both are in the NFL, I feel like it's only going to get crazier from here.
And what does your A.J. stand for?
My A.J. stands for Alvin James Green, and then I'm the third.
Alvin James Green. I see that on the on your – for those – you guys can't see. I don't know if you've seen it on Zoom, but his name, A.J. Green the third. So a family name.
Yes, no doubt. My father had it, and then his father had it. So, yeah, that's pretty much how that works.
And then if you are fortunate enough to sire a son one of these days, is it a lock automatic, A.J. Green the fourth?
Yes, it is a lock. I feel like I have to do that. My dad, unfortunately, he passed April 20th, a couple days
before the draft.
So, yeah, I feel like I have to do that. And then I feel like my son can choose after that.
Absolutely. Well, on my mom's side, there's Loy Linebarger is the name, and they're on to the fifth. They're already rolling through. Yeah. Yeah.
That's incredible.
It is incredible. How have you been during this time and with what you just shared with us? And I appreciate you sharing that. And again, our condolences. This has got to be a crazy time. You're dealing with the loss of your father. You deal with some disappointment in the draft. You're dealing with this pandemic and all this craziness. How are you doing?
I'm just surrounded by family. Just still going. I have two younger sisters, so I got to stay headstrong, stay focused. And I feel like I'm being tested, and I'm just going to push through. I'm going to break through. I know I'm going to break through, and I'm going to make my impact.
Absolutely. Where are you guys right now?
Dallas, Texas.
So that's one that obviously, if you do what you need to do, play your way on this roster, I imagine week four on the Browns schedule is circled on your calendar when the Browns travel to Dallas to take on the Dallas Cowboys for the first time in Dallas in 8 years.
Yes. Yeah. That's definitely marked. All my family was saying, oh yeah, that's going to be a crazy game coming back home to play against the Dallas Cowboys, things like that. So, I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be an incredible time.
When you come into a situation like this, and I love talking to you, you're giving me a little bit of energy, and I feel the confidence that you have. All you need is an opportunity. I'm sure that's your mindset. You're going to get that opportunity. In the bigger picture, do you see an outside corner? You're a taller corner. We see that. Is that kind of what they've talked to you about, playing that role on the outside in this defense?
Yes, they kind of talked to me about playing the outside corner. But as we get more into the playbook, I'm kind of getting the outside corner things down. So I'm transferring to trying to learn all the nickel responsibilities also because I am versatile in that aspect. And if you check the tape, I did play some nickel corner, some slot corner, things like that. So I'm just trying to be as versatile as I can, trying to make my impact on special teams, things like that. So like you said, just give me opportunity.
I was just going to ask that because that's got to be one of the most interesting things coming from college. You're in a big-time college program. You're playing a big-time position, cornerback. And then when you get to the NFL, it says, okay, it's great. You're going to be a corner. We've got some other ones, but we want you in this room. But you're going to have to be a special teams guy.
Yeah.
Were you a special teams player prior to this? Did you do it in college?
I did it in college, but it was just my freshman and sophomore year.
Okay.
My junior and senior year, they took me off special teams. I mean, I was on hands and obviously on South, but that's not any core special teams. But I'm looking forward back to it. You playing special teams at the NFL, that's the highest level. So you go down there, make a tackle, hear your name called, something like that. Or find a way, jam the gunners, or go block and kick. So I'm just looking to make an impact either way I can.
Yeah, and listen, Mike Prefer, one of my favorite guys in this organization, is a special teams coordinator, and I'm sure you're going to have a lot of fun with you. And that attitude, that's all he wants from his guys, just somebody who's willing to go out there and make a play and do what they have to do. Have you enjoyed your special teams meetings thus far with Mike Prefer?
Oh, yes, I have enjoyed my special teams meeting. I mean, I've been talking to him. He seems like a very cool dude. Can't wait to meet him in person. But then he's also about his work. That's one of the key components that we stress is work, work, work. So I'm just ready to get up there, meet him in person. I heard he was a great dude. He seemed great over the phone. So I'm just ready to play for coach.
I think that's one of the, that's got to be for you especially, going through what you went through personally, going what you went through professionally. You said you got a mountain on your shoulder. That the waiting's got to be the hardest part right now, because I'm sure all you want to do is be able to get out on the field with your teammates and start to establish your career as a cornerback in the National Football League with the Cleveland Browns.
Yes, I feel like I'm ready to get up there, ready to get our feet on some grass, things like that, and then just kind of lock in. But this, I've been taking it very mental right now. Everything we're doing right now is mental with the zone, the note-taking, and things like that. So I feel like I'm just strengthening my mind mentally now. And then when I go out there, I can play even faster.
And that's, and we all want to see you and are excited to see you. And that's one of the things that we always love this time of year is normally that rookie mini camp. And then you get the guys in who are drafted, you get the guys in who are undrafted. And guess what? At that point, we're all on the same page and you get to see people emerge. And I've seen it time and time again with the Cleveland Browns. And unfortunately that didn't happen. What was that virtual rookie mini camp like though?
I mean, early mornings, meetings, talking with Coach Stefanski, then like position meetings, and then you have special teams meetings. So I talked to some people who are in the league already. They were saying it's different in person, but I was telling me, I mean, it was still crazy over Zoom and all the meetings and things like that, but just a great experience. I'm blessed to be in this position. Like, I don't look at it as, oh, I got to go to the meeting. I look at it as, I want to go to this meeting, learn, go out there, play.
Yeah, and that's, I think that's what it's about. How have you been able to, obviously, in this very difficult time, it's not so necessarily easy to work out. What have you been able to do to keep, obviously, you're keeping your mind sharp with the meetings and the iPad. What have you been able to do to keep your body where you want it to be?
I mean, I have a corners skill specialist coach out here who goes by Flight Skills. He's pretty good. He's trained some of the top DBs. And then I have a track coach who I train with to work on speed. We go to the track and field and things like that. So that's pretty much what I've been doing. Coach B helped prepare me with the cardio and track, things like that. So that's kind of how I've been staying in shape.
That's awesome. That's awesome. And it's nice for you, especially in light of all the circumstances. You're getting to spend this time with your family while you're learning and being able to stay in shape. And so that when you come in, you're going to be coming from a place of love and ready to roll, which I think will be pretty exciting.
Yes, sir. I'm ready to get down on the ground and get rolling. Blessed to be a part of the organization in Cleveland.
We're excited to have you. What's one thing you want Cleveland Browns fans to know about you?
They're going to get everything they can out of me. I'm going to go out there. I'm going to compete. I'm not going to lay down, and I'm a winner.
I love that. I love that. All right, two ones, and one. The first question, you don't have to tell us any specifics, but clearly when you command what you commanded as an undrafted free agent, there were a lot of interested parties. How many teams had contacted you before you made the decision, and the Browns as well? Obviously, they were interested to become a Cleveland Brown.
Probably seven or eight.
That's a quarter of the league, man. That's not a small number. That's not a small number at this point. So that's awesome. And then what were those conversations like? I don't know if you got a chance to talk to General Manager Andrew Berry, but what were the conversations like, Dan Sagany, perhaps, when you decided to lock it down with the Browns?
Oh, yeah. I did talk to GM Andrew Berry. It was he welcomed me with open arms. I could feel he was genuine about everything. And like I said, it just felt right. It just felt the best decision for me. And I'm part of this organization now, so I'm ready to get rolling.
Well, we're certainly excited to have you. Obviously, a great story. I know a lot of people will be pulling for you and certainly sending their love to your family in this difficult time. And AJ, hopefully this all calms down. We can get you here to Berea. We can meet face-to-face and get with your teammates and start this journey in what should be an exciting NFL career for you. So congratulations on being in the NFL. I'm looking forward to meeting you and getting you to work here.
Yes, sir. Thank you.